Hi, this short video is just to explain to you the activity tracking options that we have in the new Moodle, or the new Enable, which is based on Moodle, and I think you'll find these rather interesting. So you might have noticed in courses built in the new Enable that they have often these little boxes down the side here, and you may have wondered what that's all about. These are called activity completion checkboxes. And let me just show you how they work. So essentially, when you set up an item in Enable, whether it's an activity or a resource, you have the option of adding an activity tracking checkbox to it. And let me just show you how that works. So I'm just going to scroll down. First of all, I'll turn my editing on, and we'll just create something in here, and you'll see how this works. Okay, so I'll just go down to say to the bottom here, and I'll say add an activity or resource, and really doesn't matter what I add because the activity tracking works on pretty much everything. So let's just say I want to send my students off to look at a particular website, and I want to know whether they've done it or not. So I can choose, I'll choose URL, which is just like a link to a website. It's a nice simple one to demonstrate. So let's just say I want them to go to the Sydney Morning Herald website. So I'll just say SMH site, and I'll just put a short description in here. Visit the SMH website. I'll even try and spell it correctly. There you go. So I've just put in my name and description. Now down here you'd put the URL that you want the students to visit. So this would be www.sydneymorningherald.com.au, let's just for example say. Now, that's fine, so you can set all that up, and really, regardless of what resource or activity you're creating, it'll have its own set of options in here. But the important thing is right down the bottom, you've got this last section called Activity Completion. And pretty much every activity has this, this Activity Completion option at the end. And just take a look at what it offers. So from this drop-down here, there are three choices. The first one is Do Not Indicate on Activity Completion. So there might be things you actually don't want to track. Could be a heading, could be a simple label on the page that you just want to indicate some text on the page. Well, clearly that's not an activity and you don't really care whether a student has interacted with it or not. So you may choose not to use activity completion for some things. The other option is you can have is for students to manually mark the activity as completed. In other words, you can leave it up to them to manually tick the box when they feel that they have completed the activity, and that's fine. You can do that. And the last one is students. It shows activity as complete when certain conditions are met. And this is where it gets kind of interesting. If you choose that, you can decide what condition needs to be met before that activity is automatically marked by Enable as completed. Now, because we've just selected a very simple one, the URL, the link to a website, there's really not much else student can do with it other than go and look at it. So once we've enabled this option here, we can turn on its only option here, which is the student must view this activity to complete it. And what that means is when the student's looking through the course and they get to that link out to the Sydney Morning Herald website, as soon as they click on the link, Enable will consider that activity to have been completed. Now, you and I both know they may or may not interact with it once they get there. They may or may not read it. You can send them to a Word document to look at, and you've got no guarantee they actually read it. But we can at least make sure that the student has looked at it. So that's how you do that. Now, if it's time sensitive, so if you expect an activity to be completed by a certain date, so for example, maybe I want my students to do this before our next lesson, I can come down here and enable this final option, expect completed on. So if I turn that on with this checkbox, which don't get confused by this enable and the fact that we've called our Moodle enable, this just means enable as in turn this option on, we can then go in here and you can choose a date. So if I want this done before next week, say, I can choose the 20th and it will add that in there. Now, when I save and return to the course and scroll to the bottom of this page, you'll see there's the link that I just put in there, and you'll notice it has a little checkbox on the side of it here. Now, as a teacher, I'm seeing it has a dotted line there. I think that's telling me that no students have actually completed that activity yet. So, from a student's perspective, anything that has been marked with that the student can mark it as complete, I can just come in here and tick it as a student and tick it off and say, oh yes, I've done that. Anything that I've set up with conditions to be met before it's considered complete, I have to actually do those conditions, and then the system will mark it off for me. So I can really easily see at a glance by looking down my course which activities I've done, which activities the system thinks I've done, and which activities I think I've done. And of course, as you see, there's some things here that don't have activity completion turned on at all. So that's how that works. Now, okay, that's great, but where do you actually find out what students have and haven't done? So if I just scroll back to the top of this course again, I'll just turn editing off. Just okay. So, as the teacher, when I come back in here and I look in my course thing here in the navigation in the side panel, and I've got my course here, 11 cap, and I've got a section here called Reports. And if I unfold that with a little arrow, there is a section here called Activity Completion. And when I click that and look at it, so you'll see here is this matrix that shows me along the top all the activities that are existing in my course, and down the side here all the students that are in my course. And I've blurred them out to try and give them some sense of privacy. But what you'll see in the grid is that any activity which has black tick boxes is an activity that the student can manually complete. Any activity which has red check boxes is an activity that the system has been set to look for certain conditions in order to consider it completed. And there are some, like you can see this one here, it's a little small to read, but there is a date there. So this is the date by which this is expected to be completed. This also has a date. This also has a date. So that was that final option where I can enable an expected completion date. And it doesn't enforce anything, that expected completion date, but what it does do is after the completion date, so this one was 7th of February, you can see it turns red. And it just lets me know at a glance which activities that I've set in here as having completion dates, and after the completion date and it turns red, it's just visually letting me know that that date has passed. And I can quickly look down the aisle there and see that, well, this red one here, there are still a couple of students who are yet to complete that task. So from a teacher's perspective of being able to see what's being done in Enable and what's getting done, what's still yet to be done, the activity completion is a pretty useful sort of a tool.